Yeah. Hello. Some of us, but actually this is a sequence from a previous event by the name of W.O.M.A.D. And this a group of people that I was working with in Bristol. We had a dream about 2.5 years ago of bringing all sorts of people from all over the world to Shepton Mallet, and there were about 600 artists from 21 countries, and we had lots of things with school kids, arts making, instrument making workshops, and all sorts of performances with rock. The end result of this was that it was a great event and it lost a pile of money. But I'm very lucky to have a group of people who are prepared to support these ideals and also back me. And in return for your cash, we will try and give you what we think you would like of this combination. This is fish farming yesterday and today, straight from the age of aquarium, the Firth The Fifth.
Thank you.
Thank you. Just a message from up here to all out there, particularly to Baker. It's a good job it isn't raining. We appreciate that you're still here. Croquet is a particularly vicious British sport. And one young participant by name Cynthia was getting so annoyed with her partner that she dug a hole in the lawn, stuck him in the center of it, buried him up, lifted up a croquet mallet and decapitated his head. This left very little of Henry. However, she was a short while later investigating his room and she discovered hidden away in a drawer, in an old desk, a strange little brown box. This she opened up, and when the figure of Henry emerged, he was there already to manifest his love for this young lady, but he grew older and older, still retaining the child's mind. This is the sequence of the musical box.
Thank you. song. Here it comes again. Thank you.
all these nostalgic throwbacks, we were thinking of all the wild times that we used to have. When we would creep into a Holiday Inn bathroom, all of us in the dead of night, unwrap a bar of soap and leave it unused the following morning. There was one incident when the birthday boy travelled up and down a German hotel lift on the top of a wardrobe with, not yet, with no clothes. But this is not one of those. This is, in fact, not a number from those days. This is another number. It's called Solsbury Hill. Thank you. Thank you. And now, I'd like to introduce you to this bunch of young musicians on the stage tonight. Over on guitar, the legendary Daryl Stermler. King of drums, Chester Thompson. Birthday boy, Michael Rutherford. And now it gives me great pleasure to introduce an unknown talent from Hounslow. A young vocalist that I'm sure you're all going to love. And he's going to sing one of his songs. This is Mr. Philip Collins. And introducing for the first time ever on the drums, Mr. Peter Gabriel. Thank you. rehearsed a little bit in Hammersmith. And on the way back on the tube yesterday, the train stopped in the middle, in between stations. The only thing that we didn't rehearse for the stories, and that was actually the wrong story. Thank you, Phil. This one actually concerns a collector, a man by the name of Saplock, who used to collect everything that he had in his life, bus tickets, paper bags, all sorts. So his room was full of junk, and every time he got more and more stuff, he had to build his house a little bit bigger and bigger and bigger. Eventually, disaster struck when his dog Ronaldo died. So he took Ronaldo to the place where all dead dogs should go, to the taxidermist. And Ronaldo was back in his room within a week, and he sat first of all on his chair, but he didn't look quite right there, didn't look very comfortable. And he tried him by the fireplace where he usually sat, and then he lifted him up in his full glory and stood him on the table. And just then, the glass eyes began to wink a little, and some sign of life returned to the dog, and his tail wagged. And as that happened, the table began sprouting branches and leaves, and everything started moving backwards into life, and the coal moved into sort of compressed gunge. And there was a strange rug just in front of the car. Fire, made out of lamb's wool. And the rug slowly returned to life, and there was a little lamb.
I'm not afraid to die. Thank you.
This is referring to the previous story, which we began in the tube train, when the train had stopped. And we were all looking around, as is all the passengers. And I noticed as a strange young lady, she was very anonymous, but she was sitting in the corner of the carriage in a green trouser suit. And when the lights went out for a moment and they came back on, she was standing in the center of the carriage. And very slowly, she began to move her hands to the center of her body and unbutton her trouser suit. She took off the top of the trouser suit and dropped it on the floor. She undid her trousers, dropped those on the floor. Undid her shirt, dropped that on the floor. And her bra, her panties, socks, shoes, until she was stark naked. Then she moved her fingers in between her legs and began looking for something. What she found was something cold, something metallic. And she pulled it slowly upwards through her stomach, through her belly button. It was a zip. And it slowly moved upwards through her body, through her breasts, up her neck, through her face, her nose, her eyes, right over her head, until she could pull it right down the back of her spine. And then with her fingers, she slid them into the crack that the zip had opened and slowly prized her body into two very neat slices, which fell to the floor. Splat. What was left where she'd been standing was one single shining rod. At this, there was an old lady sitting beside me, and she said, "This is disgusting, this is outrageous, stop it." And the rod disappeared, and all that was left was the green trouser suit with the cleaning ticket on the left arm saying, "Supper's ready."
It's been a long, long time. Hasn't it? Yeah. Stunning, man.
get going on this, just like to say a few thank yous. First thanks of all is to Tony Smith, the joint manager who conceived this whole thing and got us all back together again.
applaud you. Thank you very much. One more time, we think that considering the weather, you've been an amazing audience, so thank you very much. say thank you very much. And all of us, Mike, Phil, Darryl, Chester, Steve, Tony,